Oh, I hope this doesn't make us too sore for gardening.
Now, we're on the road to Morocco.
No, we're not. We're in Morocco, Tommy.
We've got to follow the star.
What star?
Well, I'm in front. We're off on the road to Marrakesh.
You look like you're at one with your camel, Tommy.
That's just a vicious rumour. From that camel, you know.
Are you? So you won't be getting one to park up at home?
No, definitely not. I don't think it'd go down well in Hackney anyway, you know. Well, we've finally arrived. We're here in the centre of Marrakesh in the old ancient walled Medina. And it's called, what's the name of it?
It's a famous square called Jam el Fna.
Jam el Fna.
Well, Isham is a temporary member of the team while we're here on this particular trip. He's going to interpret for us, and he also knows where we can go and buy everything and know where the school is that we're going to work on. But what he doesn't know is he might have to do some work with a pick and a hammer. Well, we've got a day to spare. We don't start till the morning. So what about me and you go get some Christmas presents?
Big. We want big.
Us on your list, remember.
You better come with us so you can interpret.
Yeah, let's go and do some shopping.
See you later.
See you later.
We're here during the Muslim holy month of Ramadan. And what the girls don't know is that any gift given, especially now near the end of the month, is deemed to be worth many times its usual value. So that should save us a few, Bob. Now, any ideas for a present for Charlie? The garden we're going to attempt over the next 3 days is a gift for a girls' boarding school in the foothills of the Atlas Mountains. And some of those foothills are being taken out of the site today by a friendly digger driver. Now that's the sort of gift we can all appreciate.
Meanwhile, just outside the Medina, in the French Quarter, Kirsty and I are off for a bit of garden inspiration in the Moroccan style. Marrakesh, famed for its gardens for centuries, was a French protectorate until the 1950s, and the French who moved here built their gardens with style.
Even Tommy would like it here, I'm sure. I know what he would say is it's very green
and blue.
Do you think Alan's painter's been here?
I think so.
Pretty fab, isn't it?
Stunning. Lots and lots of flowers. This is Jardin Majorelle, which is also known as the Yves Saint Laurent garden because they now own it, and it is fab. We're going to have a great time, aren't we?
It's just stuffed with plants, isn't it?
The gardens were created in the 20s by French painter Jacques Majorelle and have recently been restored by Yves Saint Laurent and Pierre Berger. Inspirational or what?
Amazing. These plants must grow at a rapid rate.
Hacking them back, it could be a real hacker.
No, it'd be great. Secateurs paradise. Bananas. Uh-huh. And fruit.
Yeah.
Look.
I mean, we plant bananas at home, but they don't fruit. But these ones have got fruit, and look at the flower. Very bizarre. Look at that. Well, it'd be nice to have a palm like that, wouldn't it?
Look at that.
I love the colour of the leaves.
It folds in as if there's too much material, isn't it?
Bismarckia nobilis from Madagascar. Mm. Very nice.
They've made a good job of restoring it, haven't they?
Mm. I'm not sure whether the blue will work for us, though.
No, we need tea bags. We need tea, because builders can't really work without a fresh supply of tea.
All right. These are the tea bags I talked to you about.
You'll make a perfect cup of tea out of them, Tom.
No, I don't think you quite understand. That's not the tea we're after.
Oh, of course they are. These are types of tea, just like you have the mint herbs here, All the two, the concoction of them would make a beautiful, wonderful tea.
No. I don't think you understand. Look, what we need is these little, they're like the white paper bags, and inside they've got lots of little bits of tea, and I make proper beans. So it's the start of day one, and we're taking a 45-minute drive out to the girls' dormitory, Dar Talibar, where we're making the garden. There's a secondary school here where boys and girls from the immediate area go, plus boys from further afield who can stay with members of their extended family in the vicinity. For girls, it's more difficult, and that's why the boarding accommodation has been built next door, so girls from the remote villages up in the mountains can live in a secure place and so receive a secondary education. Oh, we're here. This is it, yes. It's a bit flat, isn't it? That can't be us. Sure.
What do you mean it's a bit flat?
Look, I didn't know we were going to do Wembley, you know what I mean? So we've only got 3 days here, you know, and that's a special. You have to make it quite so large.
Well, we can just do a little bit of it. Yeah. And look at the view, Tommy. I mean,
I'm just going to go over there. I've got to have a look, investigate it.
This is where we've got 3 days. He just said to me, it's a bit flat. Now, if he'd left it with all the rocks in, he would have gone, ooh, it's a bit hilly.
We've got some nice plants down here as well, haven't we? These are bougainvillea.
Very good!
He is learning.
Oh. Bonjour.
Bonjour. Bonjour. This is Malik, the one who looks after the garden.
Okay. Malik.
The garden.
Bonjour.
Bonjour. It's Christy.
Willie. And that strange person over there is Tommy.
Looks like.
Bonjour. Enchanté.
No, you won't be later, I'm sure.
You didn't know I was, I nearly said bisexual, I'm a bit bilingual.
Well, we have the two ladies here. We have Rashida. Who is at the administration, and we have Aisha, who looks after the cuisine.
Well, important lady. Yeah.
So, explain to me a bit about this place.
Transport actually.
Well, actually, this is one of the places that have been used as a dormitory for especially the girls of the neighborhood of the High Atlas Mountains. It's part of securing the girls and at the same time to know that they are in the dormitory and that they are not somewhere else where they can be exposed to danger. Yeah.
Yes, I know exactly what she means. I've got two daughters myself.
Perfect, wonderful. قالت مع الدراري تيكون المشاكل بزاف اكثر من البنات.
تفضل الدري يخليه يمشي ويجي البنت لا.
As Rashida puts it, the boys are always given the free will to go on to take their time and everything, so they are not controlled because they know that they can manage. Whereas the girls, they always, whenever they are out, the parents always worries. So, okay.
So who are we actually going to be surprising?
Hassan Wardam, Munsiq Dial Jamiyan.
Well, we're surprising Hassan, who is the Secretary General of the Association for Development and Well-being of the whole Arica Valley.
Goodness gracious.
That's a bit of a title, that, isn't
very
it?
Very important person, yeah. I think.
Hassan's plans are nothing if not ambitious. His organization raises funds for projects across the poor rural area of the Arica Valley. And the key to sustainable development is education for all.
Et à l'étage, on a une infirmerie, on a une administration, on a une salle de réunion et Inch'Allah, une bibliothèque pour les filles, vous allez voir tout. Dans le bâtiment qu'on nous sommes en train de construire, c'est celui-là, c'est un bâtiment enfin, si on aura beaucoup de filles dans le premier bâtiment, ce sera l'extension ici.
But he's also thinking of the girls' recreation. And as well as the basketball pitch, he wants eventually to develop the gardens.
Je prévoyais de faire des bancs à côté, dans le jardin, à côté du jardin, comme ça ils se reposent pendant un quart d'heure, une demi-heure, mais pas tout le temps. Pas tout le temps, parce qu'ils doivent un peu s'occuper de leurs études. Ils sont là pour ça. Hein?
So Kirsty and I have managed to incorporate all the ideas, haven't we? Now, I have to say, it's already changed because you can't not use that view, hey? And we did have the garden looking in over there, but we've decided to flip it all the way around. So it's sort of that way now. And this is a traditional tent that some guys are coming in especially to do, because apparently it's very tricky to get these tents up. But that's going to be the focal point, looking down over the view.
Okay.
Then we got a pathway using that lovely sandstone.
Lovely, yes.
And that runs all the way down to a central rectangle with some tiles in, which will make a central feature, pots round. And then we've got some big olive trees coming that we're either going to run down as an avenue or have on each corner. And then these are pathways off of gravel to seating areas with some sort of makeshift seating in. And we've got some shading to go over the top, which are just like big umbrellas. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And then planting-wise, we're using sort of a lot of herbs, things like lemon verbena and sages and lavenders, some palms and citrus fruit and fig trees, olives, lots of sort of trees,
useful
plants, as well as being very pretty.
I understand that. Well, I support that, yeah, so you get some produce from them.
Yeah.
Now, what are these things here?
Oh,
then?
I forgot about those. These are actually poles with material suspended across in banners above, so it's like a pergola, but you don't have to build it.
Willie, what time is the flight home?
But you see these here? You didn't ask about those.
No.
Now, these are going to be bread ovens, so the girls can learn to bake bread in them. But it's a real special technique.
Very traditional, like the tent.
And I think Malik's building the bread ovens.
So he needs to get cracking, because it takes 8 days for them to dry.
He's already started mixing.
Yeah.
He's a step ahead of you guys, yeah. Oh.
So what do you think of this, ladies? What do you think is good?
It's not really confident.
Yeah.
Magnifique.
Ah, I know that one.
Magnifique. I'll tell you what, it'll be magnifique if we manage to get it done. In actual fact, it'll be a miracle if we get it done in 3 days. So on that note, I think
let's
better
perform the miracle, Tommy. Yeah.
Coat off.
Okay, guys.
You ready to go to work? Now, this reminds me of my youth, you see, because down my dad's yard, we used to make all these building materials. We used to have a Massey Ferguson tractor as well, a bit older than that one, actually. And we also had a mixer like this. And that's called a hopper, a self-loader.
So I can throw away my shovel, can I, Tom?
Thank goodness I've got Willie to do it for me now.
Do you hear me? I can throw away my shovel, then can I have a self-loading?
Well, it's sort of semi-self-loading, it's semi-automatic. It means you've only got to throw the material like that rather than all the way up into the mixer, as you know.
I've never used one of these before.
Haven't you?
No, never.
Well, I'll show you how to do it because I'm well used to it.
Yeah, you'll see it. Yeah, you'll show me how to do it.
I'll just show you.
I get him to show me lots of times. Tommy! Come here, I want you to demonstrate how this works.
It should be good for a laugh. I think it's the first time I've ever seen Tommy mix.
Well, because I've used a big bag of cement, which is the equivalent of 8 shovels of cement, you need to put in 48 shovels of sand.
Oh, lovely.
There you go, simple as that.
I don't think I quite got it. Could you go through that again for me?
These wheelbarrows were made for vertically challenged people.
Can you explain to the gentleman, there is a really big rock just here that we need to get out. Just there.
This one?
This one, it must come out. Because our trees are big.
Okay. What's wrong?
These holes here, that luckily we got the JCB to dig out the soil for us, are for the big olive trees that are turning up tomorrow morning. We've got a crane to lift them in, but while he's here, we might as well get him to dig the holes. Hey, fantastic.
For the collection.
Right, let's have a little time check. It's now 11:45 on the morning of day one. First slab about to be laid. I did ask Kirsty to try and get me some uniform natural paving. And this is what she came up with. You can see how that piece matches that piece perfectly. But this is a this is a natural local sandstone. It's lovely in colour, but I've got to do it sort of as a crazy paving area really, rather than a conventional paved area. The trick for doing that actually is to make sure you get all the outer edge with straight edges, and then you can fill in whatever else on the inside. The trick to successful bread oven making is to mould the wet clay over a pile of straw. That acts as a former to give the dome shape. I've done a little bit of this in England. This is what the equivalent of what we call the wattle and daub. And the ingredients for that, I should imagine, are very similar to this. It's some clay, you need some straw and some animal hair as a binder. But the X factor in the mix is, of course, cow poo. And you actually apply it the same way with your hands. It really isn't difficult. Anyone can try this. And you can actually probably cook bread in it as well. A sprinkling of cut straw stops the clay from cracking as it dries. And eventually, Malik will set fire to the straw inside to leave a hollow oven. Kirsty, how are we doing on the old slab stakes?
Well, we've got these ones here and a few over there. But I reckon we'll probably need some more, don't you?
We will, yeah. And could you get them before you go to the bar so they're a bit more even?
Cheeky.
Instead of giving me pieces of tissue paper and then great big lumps of boulder. The next. Oh. Are we going to get this done? I don't think so. I mean, look. It's 20 to 4. On day one, and there's a very good possibility that we're going to be working in the dump.
I think we should get you on Grumpy Old Men. You're a natural.
They haven't got a touch on me, I'm telling you. You wait till I get started.
After school, the girls who board use some of their time for projects like botany. They're organised by experts from Marrakesh's Natural History Museum and an enthusiastic ethnobotanist from the University of Kent's Anthropology Department, Gary Martin. The aim is to maintain traditional knowledge held by village folk, to stop it being lost when people go away to school. He's also the dynamic director of the Global Diversity Foundation that works in many parts of the world, and he's been invaluable to us when preparing to do this garden. In a crisis, call for Gary.
Now, we have a slight problem. Tommy's actually moving much quicker on the paving than we expected.
Which is good.
Which is good, but we're running out.
Well, that's not a problem. There's absolutely plenty of them up in the mountains. I hope you don't mind going into the clouds a little bit.
Is that where the stone comes from?
That's where it comes from. Okay. And so you just find people that actually just pull it out of the hillsides. It's very easy to get. I'm going to be up there with a few of my colleagues. We're working up in the mountains on a medicinal plant project, collecting some of the things they use locally.
All right.
So we'll find somebody to translate for you.
So
and,
if we get stuck, we won't be...
Yeah, you won't get stuck and have somebody help you bargain for the stones as well, if you like.
All right. Come in, girl.
Okay.
Oh, indigestion. That's punishment, you know, from him up there.
Yep.
You know why? Because it's Ramadan. You're not supposed to eat.
Or drink.
Or drink.
Anything.
No alcohol.
Not even water.
No alcohol anyway, Muslims. I forgot all about that.
Yeah. Well, I've leaned out a bit for him, so.
Can we sneak off to get you some more paving, Tommy?
Oh, you think I ain't got enough of it?
I think we just better go. I'll leave him muttering.
A short drive soon takes us up into the mountains, the High Atlas Mountains, where the stone we're looking for is everywhere. It's in the buildings, the terraces, the mountains themselves. These are the villages that the girls come from who attend our school. They aren't posh girls who are off to boarding school, but daughters of hard-working families who nevertheless want to see their girls get a good start in life.
The mist descends, it gets darker. Mind you, this looks sort of good,
doesn't it? Looks lovely, doesn't it? That's the kind of thing you were talking about, do you think?
Yeah.
Lovely colour.
What do you think about this here?
That looks like there's a lot of people there. Yeah. That could be our...
Cute.
Whoa, this looks good.
It's okay.
Lots of young men to help us.
It's always good.
I think you're right, it is a sandstone.
It is sandstone. Quite rough. Yeah. So how are we going to order this then?
I know, how's your French?
Rubbish.
Oh, Gary!
Oh, hi.
Just can you come and help us translate?
I'll be right up.
So, do you think this is expensive?
I don't know, I'm relying on Gary's French to get a good bargain. How's your bartering? We know your French is good, mate.
Yeah, I know all about it. Are you finding the stones that you want to have?
It's lovely stuff.
So I think if you could get them for about 8 dirhams a piece, that's about right.
Sounds
the bigger
good.
Ones would probably be about 10.
Okay.
8 dirhams, that's 15 to the pound?
50p.
Oh, that's about 50p. Is that
very
a good price?
Reasonable.
I know, definitely don't tell Tommy that.
So what are you doing up here anyway?
Well, I'm actually working with some of the students from the school and we're making a collection of medicinal plants, so
fantastic.
Want to come
we
take
come
a peek?
This,
and, yeah, absolutely, yeah. Come along. Free trip.
I'd like a bit more,
busy.
But
down this way?
Tommy yeah. might kill us.
Yeah. Well, don't worry, there's plenty of the stone in the mountains. I mean,
see,
just,
it's everywhere, actually, yeah, by the side of the road.
And is it a sandstone? It looks like a sandstone.
No, I'm not a geologist, I'm a botanist, so I'm not going to lie. But they just basically take it out of the hillside, carry it on their back or put
really?
It on a mule, and then they put it by the roadside and sell it. Now we're coming to Brahim Rushdie's house, and this is where some of the students from the school and one of my students from the university are working on a medicinal plant collection. Please
okay.
go ahead.
All right.
Thank you.
Bonjour.
Oh wow. Oh, that's busy.
Yeah.
Very industrious.
Thank you. Just about recognize that one.
What else have we got here?
Tajides. That's, of course, from Mexico, but it's being used here just as an ornamental. And all of these, even if they come from far away, like from Chile and from Mexico, they're all useful plants. And in fact, what we're doing here is working with some of the girls from Dar Taliba, the
so
boarding school.
The girls are from the boarding school? So
Fatima and Fatima.
Oh, I can cope with that.
Fatima and Fatima.
And Latifa.
And Latifa.
And her father, Brahim.
Hello, Ray. Nice to meet you.
And Mohammed, one of my students from the university in Marrakesh. This is one of the traditional ways of learning about medicinal plants in the village, is learning from an elder, from a father, from a grandfather.
Uh-huh. And will the girls learn about this at the school then?
That's what we're doing. We're bringing these plants down to the school and they're going to have an herbarium at the school. Mm-hmm. So this will be a way that they can continue learning about traditional use of plants, even if it's not in the village context.
Right. So have the Latifa's family always lived in this village?
Well, let me just ask, ils ont toujours vécu ici, dans le village, à Itlakak? Well, both Latifa and her father were both born here, and they've always lived here, so they're really rooted to the earth.
Now, Latifa's at school where we're doing the garden with the girls, Fatima and Fatima.
That's right.
But did she go to school in the village?
Yeah, so she was in primary school here. And that's the situation, is that girls like Latifa can go to primary school in their own village, but there's no high school here. So at that point, they've got to go off to a school that's a little bit more towards Marrakesh and not up in the mountains. So having a boarding school down there is the difference for her between continuing with her education and just staying back at home.
And lucky, it's especially we've got 3 days because we're going to need it. I mean, we've got paths to go up there and down here.
And there.
Yeah, 2 paths with dog legs.
Patio area.
There and there. And another one down there.
Perhaps they'll just be happy with a square of paving and 2 bread ovens.
Yeah. Willie's busy. Could you get us over a barrel full of muck and
we'll
then,
and then
I'll make a start, yeah?
In. Okay. I'll get you to eye me in the path and I can dig the holes. Cup of tea, Tommy?
Oh, lovely. Yeah, I'll have a cup of tea, definitely.
Oh, lovely.
Oh, lovely.
Somehow I should get a red one. A cup of the Rosie Lee.
Yes, we have to bring British tea to keep British builders happy.
And this is you happy, is it? Ah, this must be the tent men. Right, Mohammed, Azdeen, I need you to explain that the tent needs to, the opening needs to be central here and look straight down the path.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. And it must be at right angles to that path.
Right.
Okay. Does that make sense?
Okay. Yeah, perfect.
I'll thank leave you to explain.
Okay. So, هل 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 المركة ديالها هي هذه؟ باش ملي يجيو من هنا يدوزوا ويدخلوا على الخيمة.
يكون الباب ديالها
يكون الباب ديالها هذا مرقل مع هذا.
So they come with good intent.
Yeah, they come with one tin.
Sounds like there's lots of foreman in there, doesn't there? I'll tell you what, Kirst, I'm in a bit of a dilemma.
Are you?
Do I want a tent in my garden first, or do I want a bread oven?
A bread oven's slightly easier to recreate at home.
And the colour I would have thought would have been light to reflect the sun, you know?
Well, no, what to say is if it's black, it'll heat you up, but when it cools down then...
So it's like sweating?
Once your sweat is dry on you, it cools you down, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And that's exactly what the black does.
Think of Omar Sharif when he was galloping across the desert. He was all in black.
Is he Moroccan?
No, but I'm sure they filmed it here. They film everything here. Life of Brian.
I think you're making them up now.
No, yeah. When Isham gets here, we'll ask him. He was listing them all.
Because he takes them all round.
Because he's on personal terms with Will Smith.
Yep.
Woo!
Took him shopping.
And now he knows Will Shanahan.
Now it seems there's a wood on the move. And for some in the past, that's been a bad omen. But in our case, it's the delivery of mature olive trees from Marrakesh.
Oh, they are quite big, aren't they?
Yeah, lovely.
and don't think we've dug them up from the wild. These ones are rescued from an area that was going to be developed, then put into a nursery, and now they're coming back into a garden. Well, this is the time to place it.
Yes.
That's what. It's twisting. It's not. It's not going to be.
Okay.
Whoa. It is low.
I think well, when, no, when it's upright, Charlie, we're going to be
so
fine.
We need to get some. Will we get a rock underneath it? More or less, we can jack the rest up ourselves.
Okay, yeah.
These trees will provide much wanted shade in the garden and a crop of olives for the kitchen.
That's better.
Hold on, hold it there.
That's fine, no more. No, that's fine.
Marrakesh was once surrounded with olive groves, fruit orchards, and even within the Medina, gardens flourished between the houses. But population growth and urban sprawl has taken its toll. Schemes like this, to save and relocate trees and to create gardens at institutions throughout the city and elsewhere, are really helping to regreen the built environment. And don't worry, olive trees are tough. They can take a few knocks.
It's been quite an eventful morning. It's 12:15, and since we arrived, we've had a portable house built, and four trees have grown really quickly. And of course, the central square is almost finished.
Now these are watering pipes to go in our olives. So we're going to sink them into the ground so that when you water them, the water gets to the roots and not on the surface. And it's a good idea to do that when you're trying to establish any big tree or shrub.
How long do they need to have these pipes in then?
Well, really, until it's established. So, I mean, a good year. I'd probably leave them in there 3 years. It's good. So we push the soil in. So that's the first of two citrus. It's an orange, and this one's a navel orange. Got really glossy green leaves, and it'll get big oranges in the summer. It's actually autumn, late autumn here now, sort of early winter, which is the ideal time to transplant plants the world over. And what I'm trying to do is narrow the view down. So we've got the olives that frame it, and then it gets narrower, and then we'll have the two citrus, so there'll be another one there. I'm glad we got the digger. It makes life so much easier.
Oh, school's out. Here come the girls. Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Ça va?
Ça va, yeah.
That's my limit of French sure. Now. Does this look like what they would like?
واش هادشي داكشي اللي بغيتو على كيبغيتو يكون ولا كيضر لكم في هادشي
It's beautiful.
But
they know that it's not yet
finished. Okay. And who's this?
She's the daughter of Hassan.
Who was surprising.
Yes,
yeah?
That's right. And she knows she has to keep it very quiet from her dad.
Oh, well, yes. Well, yes, she is.
What's her name?
Smith.
My name is
Nadia.
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 I believe you're going to do a dance for us tomorrow night.
I think it's called a fatour. Fatour?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. They'll go for it. They'll go for it all.
Bilingual Tommy, then.
Not bad.
Ooh.
Au revoir.
Homework now.
They can all speak better English than us, anyway.
Yeah.
What's happening with this, Willie? It's a bit of candy floss you're giving me, eh?
It wasn't me that mixed up for you, Tom. It was the director, John Harnicraft,
was it?
Yeah.
Maybe you should tell him to stick to direction.
Maybe you should tell him.
Wow, that's something. This is really coming along, huh?
We're getting there. We've still got a lot to do tonight because we've had to adapt slightly because there's just too much to do within the time. So these paths, these long paths, we're going to infill with concrete and then a gravel surface to give us like a river of gravel running through, but it'll be fixed to concrete.
Nice idea.
It was great going up to the mountains last night and seeing Latifa's dad.
You enjoyed it up there?
I did. Tell me, would it be a big thing for him to send his daughter away?
Well, it used to be. I mean, in the sense that fathers would tend to send away their sons, and they didn't mind that they would go to these schools that were down in a bigger village. But it wasn't very well seen socially to send your girl away.
Right.
It didn't have the right implication.
Right.
Now, what's interesting is that a few years ago, the king of Morocco said, look, we should really be giving girls a good education. Education for girls is the basis of development. They're going to get a good education, probably get married a little bit later, have kids a bit later, have smaller families, families that are better taken care of. And so he really started to push, particularly in rural areas, that girls would go to school. Now, that was good, but what he also did was started to be very supportive of things like Dar Taliba. In fact, did you know he came here himself, the King of Morocco, and inaugurated this in 1999. And he said, this is the model for what we'd like to do for girls' education all around Morocco. It's interesting because in the past what was going on was that people were hesitant socially to send their girls. Now they're hesitant to keep them back.
Yeah.
Because everybody's now it's switched over to the other side. People are saying, well, no, we really should be sending our girls to school, and that's what the trend is right now. So now you're finding that the first year that this started, 1999, there were 37 girls. Then last year there were 86.
Right, cool.
And it's starting to grow more and more. And as you've looked around, you see they're building yet a new dormitory.
Yeah.
So there's going to be room for over 100 girls, and that's just continuing to go.
Any more than that, and the Skarn's going to be a bit crowded, I think.
Yeah.
I think they'll have to turn it into another dormitory.
Vaguely happy with that.
Yeah.
Glad we're doing
You've got to keep it clear of the joints as you do it, Kirst. That's it. So take your time, you ain't got to go mad. Are you nearly done?
Yeah. Almost.
Yes.
I think so.
A few more handfuls and we'll be there.
Uh-huh.
And we're very lucky. Where are you? Oh, there you are. We're very lucky because the cameraman's got a nice battery light on top of his camera. Otherwise, we wouldn't be able to see it in this last bit. It's almost black, and we're going to have a night in the souk, and we might even buy a couple of Christmas presents.
Yay!
Good night. We're off.
Right, go, guys. Ooh, can't move.
It's a free table.
Yeah, right in the best place as well.
Oh, lovely.
Oh, shuffle round.
I need to sit down. Oh, my back.
Aching bits.
Now, this must be that tea that Isham was talking about, you know?
Mint teas.
It's good for your tummy.
Yeah.
God, can you drink that? Oh, that's lovely. Lucky I've got the reserve. No, I can't drink that.
That's nice.
So this is the famous Lardy Vlardy Square, is it?
I see you got the name off Pat then.
I can't remember it.
It's a World Heritage Site though for storytelling. That's what all those groups of people are down there, telling stories. Get down there, mate.
I'd get a living, wouldn't I? Satellite TV may have arrived in Marrakesh, but you can't beat live entertainment. And Jemaa el Fanar Square is the place to get it. It's the same here every night, and it's been going on like this for centuries. It's certainly not something laid on for the tourists. It really is a remarkable place. And this looks interesting.
Sunlight. Well, being able to see it makes a huge difference.
It does.
What do you think, Will?
It's not bad, it's okay.
Don't sound too enthusiastic, mate. Good morning, day three, and there's only three of us. Tommy's feeling slightly under the weather, but there's an up point. His mind is still working, isn't it?
Yes. I saw him this morning, curled up in his bed, and he has a list of, if you could just lay out the tiles dry, then if you put the paving down dry around the edge, then get on with the screens, then the pergola, and he might be back to help you with the benches.
In 3 days' time.
Right, anyhow.
It's afternoon, I think.
Let's get that saw bench going, because we've got to get that on that side.
I do some pegs.
Yep,
you get that.
Framework. Now we need to peg it. It's good not having Tommy here. You can walk straight across the painting.
Don't tell him I said that.
On the other hand, every minute he isn't here makes more of a mountain we have to climb. Some of the girls are down in the nearest village learning all about how to bake bread in the traditional way. In the future, they'll be able to do this in Malik's bread ovens up at the school garden. The bread's for tonight's special fattur to be enjoyed by all the dignitaries, including His Majesty Mohammed VI's local representative, the governor. So we'll have the bread for tonight's breakfast. But without Tommy, we may not have a garden finished to celebrate in. We are expecting a bus from town with Gary and some extra gardening help. Let's hope Tommy's on it too.
Well, that sounds hopeful. Here's Gary. I don't know whether he's got Tommy with him. No, no Tommy still. Uh-oh.
Charlie?
Oh!
How's it going there?
Oh, not bad, but as you know, we still haven't got Tommy, still not very well.
He's had to stay back, hasn't
We've
he?
Got the benches to make. Have you got anyone that would be able to make just something simple about that long, about six of them, three for each area, or even four would do?
Easy to do.
There's That's
always,
you,
there's
is it?
Always a solution. I'm not a carpenter, but the nephew of one of the gardeners is a carpenter.
Oh, that's fab.
And
then.
I got him to come along as well, so right, he should great. Be able to help out on that.
But will you be able to translate for me?
Absolutely. We'll handle all that. If you've got the wood and you've got the tools, we can do it.
Right.
L'autre personne, vous savez utiliser ça ici? Alors, elle va partir chercher l'autre. Voilà.
Will's got the pergolas started. Gary's marshalling the troops. And our extra carpenters cracking on with the benches. Time to concentrate on the plants.
Now, Kirsten and I were just talking. There's lots of plants here we recognise, like myrtle.
Yep.
Really nicely scented. And it's known as the love herb at home.
Oh, is that right?
Yes, it's sort of romance.
Well, I'll tell you what its symbolism is here. It's a bit different. It's the plant you traditionally bring to the graveyard.
Oh. All right, then we're moving along. We got
don't want that one, do you?
Cannas and sage and the polygala. But yeah. What, do tell me, is this?
You're going to put me on the spot here, aren't
you? What? Oh, just like...
You've,
what is it?
You've come to the right person, because this one, thank God, I do know. That's the Eugenia. And that's in the Myrtaceae.
Oh, okay.
See, opposite leaves, pretty common feature of the Myrtaceae and this right. type of fruit. And I think that's okay.
Sadek
probably told you that one is edible.
And what's it like? Peppery? Go halves?
Okay.
Don't put your spittle over it. You could have just broken it off. Thanks, mate. Oh, and I've got the muddy side.
That's a muddy side too. What are you going to leave for me then?
Oh, it's crunchy. I think that might be the...
It's crunchy. Oh, you're going to leave through the pit.
But you can plant that and grow another one.
Okay, we'll plant another one.
All right, well, we're going to start placing now. So your boys that are doing the gravel, once we've got them all placed, they can start planting.
Okay, good.
How are you doing, all right?
Hi, we're getting there. We've got our machine digging over the planting ground, and then we'll get that placed and get the guys to dig our holes for us. And we should be all right, and then we'll kind of move on. You'll have that pergola up by then.
Who will?
You will.
That might be the case, but without Tommy to finish the final square of paving, we're staring disaster in the face.
Now, I always tell my kids there's always a solution.
Uh-huh.
And in fact,
go on, tell me what it is.
Well, if you look over there, you see the building.
That's
the same stone that you're laying here.
Right.
And the folks that are building that building are the specialists.
Oh, is that them, is it?
Yep.
Voilà. Bonjour. One.
Bonjour, ça va?
Two. Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Fantastic. Ça
va? And they're the specialists. That's what they do day in, day out, year after year.
Off they go,
and
then.
And so they can get that wrapped up for you pretty quickly.
Yeah, that's great.
Shall we get to it?
Yeah. Three, away, go! Whoa! Merci! What's the time?
It is 2:30.
2:30, 3:30, 4:30.
Two and a half hours. Still no sign of Tommy though, is there?
Now, you might think this is an ivy, but if you look, it's got these little yellow flowers, and it's a senecio, and it's macroglossus, and it's got variegated leaves that are really podgy and succulent. Now, it is a climber. You can grow it at home inside, in a hanging basket looks really nice, but here I'm going to use it as ground cover. And it's quite a good idea sometimes to use climbers as ground cover. Really good ones, Clematis montana, really vigorous, got flowers, and it'll sprawl all over the place and suppress all the weeds. Oh, I think they've only just been potted up.
You're going to the hole on the right, Gary.
I'm going over to the one.
Yeah.
Over there, swinging over.
Now this is a really beautiful palm. It's Bismarckia nobilis, and it's got these really glaucous blue leaves, very sort of palm-shaped. But the best thing about it is it's going to get really big, fill that whole space, and the trunk gets this crisscross of lattice work where the sort of leaf stems are. Fabulous.
There we go. Oh, sorry about that.
That's all right.
Had another helper there.
Fine job.
Okay.
Come.
Kirsty, you're not getting that sawdust all over my paving, are you?
Oh, don't start.
Excuse me, who did the centre of the paving?
Yeah, well, you'll get sawdust on your half, but keep my half clean.
No.
Woo. Now, Will, did you allow 6 inches?
I did, yes. Either side.
These aren't longer.
Do you want to tape 6 inches from either end?
Well, you can't see the pole, can you?
Right, go to you a bit.
Me.
That's good.
Très bien. Perfect. Wow. Merci beaucoup. You saved the day. You'll have to say to them that they've saved the day.
At last, the bus from town. Could this be the arrival of our knight in shining armour? Perhaps not.
In the immortal words of Arnie Schwarzenegger, I'm back. Well, most of them.
How are you doing, my dear? Oh. You look bad. You just leaned down.
Yeah, in 8 years, I've never missed 5 minutes of this show. It's amazing, isn't it?
What
at least
think,
one good
then?
Thing out of it, I'm a lot lighter than I was last night. Let's have a look.
Mind your pointing.
I think you should just take it easy in the shade here.
Yeah, it's looking great.
Yeah?
You've really done marvellous.
You look all washed out, mate.
I think he's just going to have to lie down. His legs are a bit wobbly. He's brought spare clothes with him.
Just emergency, aren't you?
You get through there.
I'm sure we'll find you a wee cushion. You'll be all right.
I'll get up. Just give me a minute.
Okay. A bit important, doesn't it?
Yes, indeed.
Flash car.
Well, that could be.
Mm. I'm Gary's sure we'll find out.
I know. As long as it doesn't take long, that's right.
It's Governor Mohammed Iknaren. Now, if he's here, the rest of the official visitors ain't far behind.
He organized the tent for us. So it's really a good participation. It's, of course, the English from the BBC who sont venus to tout faire, mais avec la participation des gens qui nous aident avec le jardinage, avec le dallage, avec différentes choses.
C'est formidable.
Kirst.
Yep.
We got an hour. We'll have to stop planting plants, move them to the side, just tidy, and then we're going to have to finish the pergola because that's much more important. The guys can always plant the plants.
Absolutely.
People can start washing up the tools. That'd be good for us. Stacking them around the corner. Wheelbarrow and covers. Grab the covers and we can use those. Ponies.
Smoking. Okay, c'est bon. Bonjour.
Merci. Dès que j'ai quelque chose, j'appelle.
These ones seem higher. Can't be. Did you screw that one up?
What?
Did you screw that one up? Okay. Next one. Hey. Oh. Hey. Yeah, I'm not going that way.
I must have about 10 seconds now, I think.
Right.
That way, just a wee bit, but it's
there. Okay, this is it. He's coming.
He's coming out right.
Hassan, bienvenue.
Merci.
J'ai travaillé un petit peu avec les filles de l'école dans les derniers jours.
Quelle surprise.
Vraiment.
Vraiment, c'est une belle surprise.
Mais en fait, j'avais l'aide des amis de l'Angleterre. Vous savez? Voilà, je vous présente Kirsty King.
Vous avez réalisé.
Exactement.
Je vous remercie. Je vous remercie. Je vous remercie. Et vous avez réalisé l'un de mes grands rêves.
Voilà.
C'est pas vrai. Et pourtant,
vous voulez visiter un petit peu le jardin? Voilà. Vous avez encore, des amis là-bas qui sont venus.
C'est trop.
Voilà.
C'est trop. C'est normal.
Vous allez dire bonjour. Il y a beaucoup d'espace pour les filles, il y a des bancs. Et vous voyez ici, il y a des fours à pain. Comme ça, les filles peuvent faire de pain. Alors, vous pouvez découvrir tout.
Merci.
C'est une surprise de BBC Ground Force.
Je vous remercie au nom de l'association. En mon nom propre. Je suis vraiment très ému.
He's very, very touched.
Vous avez réalisé un de mes rêves.
You've completely realized one of his dreams.
Oh. Wonderful.
Yeah.
Mais je vous remercie au nom de l'association, en mon nom personnel, pour tout ce que vous faites pour nous, pour les jeunes filles.
He thanks you from his part, from the association, from everybody here, from the girls in the school, he really thanks you very deeply for the surprise.
It's a pleasure.
Cette fois, vous m'avez eu, hein?
Oui. We got him, is what he just said. You really got him.
That's the whole idea.
There's plenty of Morocco in this garden, from the local pots, stone and fabric, to much of the planting.
The central red square, shaded by the new olive grove, leads off to the four corners of the garden. And back to the shelter of the tent. A welcome refuge that I, for one, can vouch for.
It's a young garden that will grow and blossom in the future, just like the girls at this fantastic school.
This is the prayer at dusk. It allows people to break the fast. What they do here is to take dates and milk. That was the most traditional way.
We should say to you, happy breakfast.
Bon petit déjeuner.
At dusk. So, from all the Grand Force team and everyone who helped, till the next time. Un, deux, trois.
Au revoir.
For information about environmental and educational projects in Morocco, visit the website.